I'm gonna ask you questions if you can answer, so hopefully I can hit all the important. How do you prepare for the test? I think you prepare every day. I mean, I don't think there is any special preparation required, you know, 1 day or 2 days prior to. I told you, hey, take notes in class. If you're not taking notes, I think you are probably placing yourself at a disadvantage, okay? That's what I think, you know, you want to take notes. Of course, the finance I cover with you is the same finance covered all over the globe, okay? But it's the emphasis, it's what I bring from my experiences, from not only this textbook, but from other textbooks, so I give you different examples. So the emphasis could be different, maybe some points are not covered in your text, maybe they're covered differently. So that's why I always advise students to take notes, okay? It's always a good idea. Not everything, just write down the important things, important definitions, you know, something that strikes you as important, you know, whatever it is. So use my lectures as the basis, okay, for preparing for your test. Use your class notes as the basis. Once you have the basis covered, once you know the definitions of, you know, I would encourage you to read the textbook, as many pages as you can, okay? All of the textbook, if you can. But if you cannot, then, you know, at least make sure that you come to class every day, take notes, you know, so that you have, you know, something to use, you know, before the test, okay? So this is just an outline I provide you, but, you know, it will help you pass, you know. I don't know how far you will get by just focusing on these outlines. Maybe you can make an A, I don't know, you know, maybe you'll make a B, but surely I think if you just cover the basic, you should pass without any problem. Okay, so what's the goal in finance? What? Yes?
Create value.
What's the goal of corporate finance? Maximize shareholder value, maximize the stock price. Okay, maximize, so that's creating value. Okay, if the stock price is 10, tomorrow it goes to 11, like a GE. It was in the news today, General Electric, news today, they are selling their healthcare division. They are selling to another firm, and the stock price shot up because people believe it's a good thing. You know, you are not managing your asset well, so you are selling it to someone who can, you know, manage. So both the buyer and the seller, they are creating value this way, okay? It's a bad idea to continue running a business the way you have been if the business is not producing any value, okay? So that's why it's a good idea. Get rid of it if it's not working. Maybe somebody else can, you know, use this asset, you know, for a different purpose and create value. So that's what our job. So the stock price, GE stock price, if you watch, it went up by more than a dollar. It went up, I think, about $1.50, $1.50. So that's what value creation is. Take some steps so that investors see that you are doing the right thing and they cause the stock price to go up. Okay, so your job is to create value. In corporate finance, our job is to maximize the stock price or maximize shareholder value. Remember, I must have, or stockholder value, or maximize firm value, okay? So same thing, synonymous thing. Or maximize the value per share of current stock, of current equity. Maximize share, you know, a value per share of current equity. So same thing, okay? Maximize profits? No, we don't want to maximize profits. So here, these are examples of what we do in class. What is capital structure? What is capital structure? What do we mean by capital structure? Mix of debt and equity. How we finance our firm. Mix of debt. Can we create value by changing our capital structure? You bet you can. How? Suppose Google does not borrow money, but then it starts to borrow money. How can corporate borrowing create value? Who will tell me? How can corporate borrowing create value? Anyone?
Lower taxes.
Lower taxes. How?
Lower taxes.
How? You're right, but how will the taxes be lowered?
Interest expense.
Interest expense is tax deductible. So you borrow money, if you are Google, you show the interest expense, you know, on your tax returns, lo and behold, your taxable income goes down, your taxes go down, so you create value. Okay? What are good projects? So you want to finance your firm in some optimal fashion. So, you know, finance your firm, use the right amount of debt, right amount of equity. Now you have those funds, you want to make investments, you want to make good investments to create value for your shareholders. What is a good investment?
One that promises more return than the
Yes. A good investment is one that promises a higher return than what you require based on the risk of that investment. Remember that? Okay. That's a good investment. All right. What is working capital?
Current assets.
What is net working capital? It's not here, but you need to remember. Total current assets minus total current liabilities. Okay, can you name the assets that fall under current assets? Name three of those for me.
Cash,
accounts receivable, inventory. Cash, accounts receivable, inventory. Okay. Can you name some current liabilities? Accounts payable? Notes payable or short-term loans. Accounts payable, note payable. And there is another thing, accruals. Accruals are, we haven't covered it, so accruals are taxes that have accrued or wages that have accrued you haven't paid. Accruals, A-C-C-R-U-A-L-S, accruals.
So accounts payable.
Notes payable, short-term loans, same thing. Okay, tell me the three problems with profit maximization. Ignores risk, profit maximization. We don't maximize profits because if we maximize profits, we also maximize risk.
Ignores
the time value of money. Ignores cash flows. Okay, so we focus on cash flows. Profits that you see on a firm's income statement, they are not equal to the cash flows. Okay, they are fictitious profits. Those are fictitious numbers. Okay. How did General Motors show higher profits one quarter or 1 year?
They decreased
the depreciation expense. So what was the impact on profits? The lower the expense, right? The higher the profits. Okay. And depreciation is what? Is it a cash expense or a non-cash expense?
Non-cash.
Depreciation isn't. So it does not really matter as far as the underlying cash flows are concerned. These are just manipulations. Okay. All right. The agency problem.